Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Our Lord is good. Praise the Lord, children of Zion. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord God Almighty. Our Lord is a great God. We are serving a mighty God, the wonderful God, the God of mercy, the incomprehensible God, the omnipotent, omniscience, omnipresence. That is the God we are serving, a mighty God, the mighty one in battle, the Lion of tribe of Judah, the God that maketh possibility to be possible, the God that maketh a way when there is no way. That is the God we are serving. God bless you all in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. It's me, your sister, your friend, your girl, Holiness. God bless you all in the name of Jesus. I want to use this opportunity to thank all my fans out there. May the Lord God Almighty bless you all in the name of Jesus. Please, if you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. If you have subscribed already, may the Lord God Almighty bless you all in the name of Jesus. You are all blessed in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, children of Zion. Praise the Lord, children of God. You are all blessed in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Before we start, let us pray. Heavenly Father, I thank you for this wonderful day. Thank you for the gift of life. Thank you for everything you have done in our life. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your greatness upon our life in the name of Jesus. Thank you, O Lord, for everything you have done. Father, if we have mouth all over our bodies, not enough to thank you. Lord, I come to say thank you. Because you are the reason of this season, the reason why we are alive today. That if it's not you, I don't know where we could have been today. Lord, I praise your holy name. I bow down my head before you to say thank you, Jesus. I come before you today, O Lord, to say thank you. Because you have done a great and mighty thing in our life. Father, Lord, I praise your holy name. I reverence your holy name. Immortal Redeemer. Thank you, Father. I cover every one of us with the blood of Jesus. Father, every power that you stand against this prayer, I take authority over them, bind their power in the name of Jesus. Every monitoring spirit, spirit of distraction, spirit of mistake, the power that will make us, any spirit that will make us not to believe in your word, I take authority over them, bind their power in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. I cover this prayer with the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for answering our prayer. In Jesus' mighty name I pray. Amen. Hallelujah, children of Zion. You are all blessed in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Before we start, let's open our Bible in the book of Mark. In the book of Mark. Hallelujah. Let's open our Bible in the book of Mark. Praise the Lord. Children of Zion, praise the Lord. Our Lord is good. Hallelujah. In the book of Mark, Mark 16, verse 15. Mark 16, verse 15. The Bible said, and he said unto them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Hallelujah. Mark 16, 15. The Bible said, we should go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. My dear brothers and sisters, we are the one that will represent our Lord Jesus Christ. Remember, when our Lord Jesus Christ was in this world, he preached all over the world. He preached and he was telling us the way, the heaven, the thing that we will do to make heaven. My dear brothers and sisters, look at the things our Lord Jesus Christ do on this earth before he died because of our sin. My dear brothers and sisters, we are the one that will represent our Lord Jesus Christ. We have to serve God. We have to work for him. The Bible said, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. What is keeping you busy? What are you doing that make you to think that you cannot do it? You can do it, my dear brothers and sisters. You can do it. It's not that difficult. You can do it. Hallelujah. The Bible is telling us, say, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. You can do it. Anyone can do it. Because our Lord Jesus Christ has given us the strength, the power, the wisdom, the anointing already. The anointing is upon you, is upon me. So we can work for God Christ. We can work for God. We can win souls for Him. We can tell the world about Christ. Hallelujah. My dear brothers and sisters, don't be too busy. And don't think that you are too shy. You cannot do it. You can do it. If you present your life and if you submit yourself to Christ Jesus, you will do it. If you submit yourself to Christ and say, God, Lord, I want to work for you. Strengthen me. Empower me. You can do it. He will answer you. I want to ask one question. Is there something too hard for our Lord Jesus Christ cannot do? There is nothing too hard for Him. He can do all things. All power belongs to Him. Hallelujah. I pray as we hear this word today, we will be the hearer and the doer of His word in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. God bless you all in the name of Jesus. Please, my dear brothers and sisters, let's open our Bible in the book of Job. Hallelujah. In the book of Job 22, verse 27, I read, the Bible said, thou shalt make thy prayer unto Him, and He shall hear thee. When you pray to God, He will hear you. When you pray to God, He will hear you. Our Lord Jesus Christ, our God is not a man. When you ask something because of what you did to Him years back, He will not answer you. He's a merciful God. He will hear you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Job 22 verse 27, the Bible said, thou shalt make thy prayer unto Him, and He shall hear thee, and thou shalt pay thy vow. When you pray to God, He will hear you and you will pay your vow. Hallelujah. Verse 28, the Bible said, I shall also decree a thing, and it shall be established unto thee, and the light shall shine upon thy way. You shall also decree a thing, and it shall establish. The light of God will shine upon your way. My dear brothers and sisters, we are too weak to ask. We are too weak to pray. Whenever we pray, God answers prayer. We shall also decree a thing, and it shall establish, and the light of God shall shine upon us. We are too weak to pray. We have the strength to do things for ourselves, but the time of prayer, we are weak. Father, eternal rock of ages, every spirit of weakness in our life, I command it to destroy right now in the name of Jesus. Those power, those spirit that is around us, making us to weak, not to pray, not to serve you, not to fast, not to work for you. I take authority over the kingdom altar, over the spirit, over the power in the name of Jesus. So shall it be in Jesus' name. Amen. There are some people, they can work January to December. But when you call them to pray just 20 minutes, they are so weak. They don't have the strength to pray. Hallelujah. The Bible said, we shall also decree a thing, and it shall establish, and the light of God shall shine upon our way. When you ask, when you open your mouth, when you pray, God Almighty will answer you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Verse 29, the Bible said, Job 22, verse 29, the Bible said, when men are casting down, then thou shalt say there is lifting up, and He shall save the humble person. When people are saying there is crisis, because you have God in your life, because you obey His commandment, because you do things that please Him, He will bless you. In the time of famine, you will not experience it. In the time of situation, it will not come you, come closer to you. Hallelujah. In the time of famine, God will bless you. Anywhere you go for favor, God Almighty will favor you. Because you do things that please Him. Because you obey His commandment. Because you have a good relationship with Him in the time of famine. When people are saying, hey, there is no food, there is no job, there is no document, there is no money, God will provide it for you. You will be different than others. Hallelujah. My dear brothers and sisters, He said, when men are casting down, Lord Jesus Christ, because of the relationship you have for Him, because you obey His commandment, He will bless you. You will not experience any famine. In the time of sickness, they will not come near you. In the time of trial, you will not experience those things. When those things are coming, He will take them away from you. He will fight those battles for you. Hallelujah. Please, that is why when people are preaching, come closer to God. Serve God with all your heart. Follow God. Accept Christ as your Lord and your personal Savior. People will just take it as nothing. With God, all things are possible. Where others are go, they fail them. They reject them. You will go, they will accept you. Because of the mercy of God. Because of the relationship we have for God. Because you obey His commandment, you work for Him. You do things that please Him. He will defend you. He will make it possible for us. Others will be crying. You will be laughing. You will be rejoicing. Hallelujah. Please, my dear brothers and sisters, let's follow the way of Christ. Let's follow the way of God. Let's obey His commandment. I pray that God Almighty will help us in the name of Jesus. Whatsoever that will make us to disappoint God, I cancel those evil away from our life in the name of Jesus. Anything that will make us to be a disobedient child to God, I cancel it in our life in Jesus' name. God Almighty bless you all in the name of Jesus. Remain blessed. Please leave a comment, like. If you can share, you share. God bless you all in the name of Jesus. Amen.